Make it tackle. Make it tackle. Yeah, why would you piss me off? Why would you do that?
Where are we at right now?
Like the hotel, you just right now we're in San Francisco for the ultimate kickoff tourney.
I dare you, Doug. I dare you.
It's the ultimate kickoff live from Redwood City as we get not only the football season underway, but the Madden season underway. Ready to go, and no doubt the GOAT, the six-time belt winner, Henry Leverett, is ready to get back that title and keep adding to the trophy case.
My motivation going into this tournament is I want to get that first in-person belt. You know, I have 5 belts, but I don't have that in-person belt yet.
Real steppy, just walked in. What W at? W. Christopher. You, we been in that own side kick, right? The high kick? What? You want to leave the high kick shit? Fucking knew it, bro. I knew King wasn't going to be the only person, bro. I fucking knew it. How you feeling, Gabriel? I heard King wasn't doing it. I'm like, fuck, I gotta go ask Dubby, bro, for some bullshit.
Hey, what's up, bro?
Wait, are y'all playing each other?
No, he's playing Trick Slimy Worm.
Nigga, Trick Slimy Worm before a tournament is crazy. Are you trying to win?
A fucking chicken sandwich, man. Yeah,
better team for 17. I didn't know he was moving like this, so I wouldn't have said that. I didn't know he was moving like this.
That white team, bro.
Gabby got one. Gabby won.
The 4 bites.
This is crazy.
Yo. This shit
was wrong. I was watching King play earlier.
Huh?
He was getting punished by somebody. So I was watching King play earlier. Yeah.
What's up, Microsoft? Huh? I can't say nothing crazy.
I can't say nothing.
It won't make
it. The favorite thing about coming to the live events is meeting everybody that I talk to every day online, you know, all the other great Madden players, you know, John Beast, Gabagol, Drini, Dez, K-Mac, everybody, you know, seeing them in person, being able to chill with them and see how they are outside of Madden. That's what I look to for it the most.
John, you in shambles right now, bro.
John, you gotta click on shit.
Have you ever drank before, like, a tournament? Is your first time? Did I, like, influence you badly?
Thing about Dubby, man, is he's really respected in community, you know, great player, even better streamer. So I have a lot of respect for Dubby, but as far as like competition wise, you know, definitely a little shook, If you were watching my streams or anything, you saw while I was playing, I would turn on Dubby's stream and I would just be sitting there in shock because I'm like, Dubby actually looks really good at this game. So, you know, the fact that I got him first, it's definitely a little shookingly.
Describe him as methodical. This is somebody who doesn't get flustered by different looks. He's gonna find his adjustments. He's gonna make every play look different. He's just tough of a player to defend. Boom, back to pass. Four man rush. Oh, he got the D-line pick! Blood with the pick into the house!
Go get him! Hey, Dub is not playing. The way he took this at, Henry was patient. Got him right here.
Got him
nice
on the top. Line. Over the top. Devin Hester in the Bears uni. To the house. A sight we have seen so many times. It's a big 4th-and-4 here for Dubby. Trying to keep the advantage in this 14-7 game. Nearing the end of the first quarter. We're under a minute to go. Bunch to the right side. Solo receiver to the left.
And in the left side, they're setting up all his.
Three-man rush.
Perfect.
He's looking over the. It's not
here.
There. Henry's defense gets a stop.
We know that Dez is a defensive player. Yeah. Henry
is it at the end zone.
Every time the slot receiver Jerry Rice, Dubby's trying to go deep with him on streak. He's got a deep zone back there with it. This time he doesn't.
No, nothing.
Dubby can't take advantage.
I dare you, Dubby. I dare you.
You go.
Hey, you got it. Your time has passed.
Called him a relic.
He
said, I dare you.
I mean, I'm just saying.
No,
why the would you go for it? I just told you not to do that. I just told you not to do that.
I like it.
You know Henry knows every route he wants to go to, and that's hurt Dubby so far in this first half.
Easy.
That crosser, he's got him short. 15, 10, stop and go. Make I mean, an unbelievable performance. The main event of our evening. It is Henry moving on to the semifinals.
Yo, what's up? This is me after the W game. Close game in the beginning, but I feel like I turned up, really dominated the game from when he scored his second touchdown. I just stayed composed, did my thing. But really, today was like a bunch of great games, starting with the Des K-Mac game. I mean, that game went down the wire. And then right after that, John B's Gabagol, two-point conversion for the win. Nothing really there. So Gabagol moved on, who also happens to be my opponent tomorrow. So I got to lock in on that game, figure out how to try to stop him. Really, I got to go back and watch everybody's game. Got to go see what Dez didn't like. I got to go see what Drini didn't like. You know, try to see if I can mix that into my own adjustments. So just happy for tomorrow. And I just got to get in that lap for real. Gabagol, great player, not the best on defense, really known for his offense. You guys saw in his game yesterday versus John Beast, didn't miss a single read. And if he did miss a read, he also had another one open, so he's just a great offensive player. Dez and Drini are kind of like one and the same. I feel like that's going to be a great clash. They're both defensive players who struggle versus other defensive players. So I don't know what's really going to go on in that game. If I had to choose, I would say Drini, but I wouldn't be surprised if Dez won at all, you know. It's like the perfect matchup for each other, so it's going to be a tough game. Should be a great game to watch.
And over the top of the post, drag has a backside C route. The running back route is good. There's so many good routes on that play.
Right side, he's got it over the top, open, and walk into the end zone. Touchdown, Henry, quick response. One right, here comes the pressure. Gets rid of it over the middle of the field. Picked up, it's Cromartie. And going the other way is Henry. 15-20, he's inside the 30. Can he make a man miss? Juke move inside. He'll get up near mid.
Yeah, why would you piss me off? Why would you do that? Why would you do that? You gonna get it back? Are you high? Are you crazy?
47 yards.
The last thing you want to do is put the battery in the back of the
Yo, move back to pass. It's a pressure right up the A-gap. He looks over the top. Does he have him? It's Devin Hester in the Bears uni. Devin Hester might be sending Henry to a final five. Touchdown the five time.
He's a little boy. He's a little fucking boy.
Headset is off, and it looks like we are destined for a rematch. It is official. We will have the Madden Bowl rematch as the number one player in the world. Henry will take on the man who believes he should be the number one player in the world, Dez. A hard-fought battle from Gabagol, but in the end of the day, it was Henry's second-half performance that put him over the top.
Yeah, so while I was playing Gabagol, he was talking really loud, so I could, like, hear him a little bit. And I heard him say, "You suck." And that just, like, lit me up. I knew if, like, something happened, I had to, like, respond with something crazy. But I actually ended up talking to Gabagol after the game. Apparently, he didn't say, "You suck." He said, "This defense that I'm running sucks." I actually did apologize to Gabagol because, you know, I did go a little bit crazy on him because I thought he said this, but it really was another thing. So, as you guys know, I'm not really the one to initiate it. I always try to respond. And I accidentally responded to something I didn't even respond to.
Plus, it will be Dez battling Henry, a rematch of the Ultimate Madden Bowl from last season.
Can Henry check that box, finally win a live event? There's so many storylines and so much expectation. Legacy is on the line right now.
The loss against Dez in the Madden Bowl, yes, it definitely hurt. It definitely hurt. That was like a $100,000 game. Dez was having like the year I had previously in 22. We both had won the belt, so it was a pretty big game. So losing that one hurt a lot, man. I did not like losing that. I think what would happen if I won this belt would be, I would just be richer, I guess. Richer with more belts. I guess it would change my legacy with me it being in person. But as far as like anything else, I feel like I've done pretty much everything, so it can't really, all it can do is build onto something that's already great.
You know, do you want to start with ball or do you want to go out on top?
You want to start with an interception, Ryan Hollins. It's Cam Chancellor with a pick, and there goes Henry the other way. He will take over the 41-yard line. He's up a stop.
But Beamer sideline.
Got him right side, up the sideline. Makes a man miss to the five, to the house. The first touchdown of this championship game. Steps up over the middle. The Miami hurricane, the late, great Sean Taylor with an interception.
Back to Ball, blocking our field.
Come on.
And he's into the end zone.
Ball to the house, and Henry up two scores. Right up the seam. Over. He is a high ball. And the high ball right over the head of the receiver is picked off.
He's not Henry.
Zeros are on the clock. Move over, MJ. We've got a new six-time champ. Henry Leverett is your ultimate kickoff champion.
On the line. I'm not going to lie. On the line was my legacy, man. Even though I've done a lot, you know, before, like, the game happened, I won 5 belts. I almost have all the majors in MCS, like, you know, the most amount total. I have almost every accolade, but Dez did beat me in person. You know, I didn't have that in-person belt. And Dez, he was also creeping up on my legacy. You know, he had an insane last year. If I lost that game, being that I just lost to him in the bowl, the last MCS tournament, then it being in person, you know, I was 0-2 in finals, and they both happened to have been in person. So for me to lose that game, I would have been shook if it happened. I think it was 23-0, and he was trying to drive up the field. And then he fumbled. That's when I was like, okay, it's officially over. That's when I had it in my head, okay, I won. Because even though I was going into half up 20 with the ball, I still was a little shook because I didn't really have to pass. So I didn't know how good he was on defense. I didn't have to pass at all that game, for real. It was merely really just me, like, playing defense and running the ball and taking the clock. So I felt like if he started to stop the run at all, if I had to pass, like, I didn't know if he was going to bag me or not. So I still was a little shook, honestly. Who do I see myself becoming? A harder working Henry. I for sure got to work way harder. I have, like, all the tools set. You know, I have great people around me that can help me. All I have to do is just put in the work, which you're gonna see. Who do I represent? Myself. Honestly though, joking aside, definitely I want to say my family. You know, I just want to show people that my mom and dad raised a great child. I had great family members around me my whole life. That's what I'm always going to be thankful for. So I'm always going to credit my family, you know, and they're both ecstatic. You know, my dad and mom, yeah, I talk to them after every single game, whether I win or lose. You know, my dad, he's, like, hard on me, tries to give me, like, tips, asking me why am I doing things like this when I know I should be playing better. And my mom is more of a, like, oh, my gosh, I'm with you, win or lose, you know. But, yeah, you know, fun thing I do is after every single game, the first person I try to talk to, you know, that's not in person, obviously, is my mom. I try to make sure I get my mom on the phone immediately after I win or lose, let her know how I'm feeling, let her know how things went and all of that. So, you know, to have that, be able to do that, means the world to me. Dream collab, honestly, probably Kai Cenat. It has to be Kai. I feel like I relate to him a lot. We both are short black men, but it's really entertaining, keeps me laughing all the time. We also both grew up, like, poor and stuff, so I don't know. If I could choose anybody, for sure, Kai Cenat. What song represents Henry? That is a great question. If I had to choose a song to represent myself, honestly, don't know. I could tell you my favorite song, but a song to represent myself? Hey, Family Matters, or Family is Everything by Drake, you know, off the Views album. I'll say that. Anything else I want to say? Go Bears. Justin Fields will have 4,000 passing yards this year. Fact. Couldn't give me any advice. You always had something to say every other time. Everybody that I met on the way tries to get in the way.